Sehr geehrte Zuschauerinnen, sehr geehrte Zuschauer.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Now the time has come. Now it is possible, since last week in Switzerland, what is embedded as an undisputed taboo in every indigenous people and every religion according ethnologists. Sex in public. Sex on the sidewalk, the Swiss newspaper, Blick am Abend, headlined the new so-called Stop AIDS campaign, Love Life, Don't Regret Anything, of the Swiss Federal Office of Public Health, Bundesamt für Gesundheit, AIDSHELP Switzerland, and the organization Sexual Health Switzerland. I quote the newspaper, Blick am Abend. Five couples, man and woman, man and man, woman and woman, dare intercourse in public. In any case, man, woman and children can watch them at their libidinous activities on snapshots on posters. That many citizens feel sexually harassed by these pornographic posters and children have to be protected falls on the deaf ears of lawyers and judges, but not at Klagemauer TV. Since then, a storm of indignation has reached us in these days. To make their voices heard and let it become public, here are some excerpts of the complaints.
The majority of complaints refer to the same law which is effective at the workplace. This law, called Swiss Code of Obligations, paragraph 328, and the Equality Act, paragraph 4, forbid any harassing behavior of sexual kind. There is a simple rule for the evaluation if it is a case of sexual harassment. Decisive is what is desirable or undesirable for the afflicted person, respectively, what he or she perceives as sexual harassment.
One complaint responds towards the tolerance and especially the socialists in the country. I quote, you are talking about tolerance, but where is the tolerance towards a majority of ones who do not feel the same way? You are the first ones who campaign for alleged xenophobia. Why do you allow a discrimination of those who feel harassed for good reasons by these public sex posters?
Another complaint responds to those who endorse the sex campaign. I quote, you explain to do this in order to rescue other humans. How do they take it for granted to be able to prevent one infection with AIDS by a provocation campaign? Despite the fact that this is far from being proven if the HIV virus is to blame for AIDS at all. For this, we suggest our German broadcast from December 1st in 2013.
The next complaint is directed against the tabloids, adding more fuel to the flame by printing these sex images page for page. I quote, why are you saying that this porno casting organized by the state, how Sebastian Frehner, member of the SVP National Council calls it, doesn't act as a deterrent? But only 0.003% of the Swiss people, 300 in numbers, have applied to the porno casting.
Several complaints were directed against the federal government. Quote, who has entitled them to invest 2 million Swiss francs of taxpayers' money for a public sex provocation under the pretext of prevention? Who ordered this? Surely not the taxpayer.
Several complaints have reached us because filed criminal complaints of sexual harassment have been rejected. The sex posters can't be classified as pornographic because according to Article 179, paragraph 5 of the Swiss Penal Code, they have a cultural or scientific value worthy to be protected.
So much for the excerpts of the field complaints. Since the Swiss legislative power apparently is without effect here anymore, and punishment of sexual harassment will be history from now on, several citizens saw themselves forced to stand up in their own defense. According to reports, some of these repulsive pictures were pasted over with the writing sexual harassment. Other citizens have covered them with clothes or sheets, spray paint or large X's across the posters in order to protect themselves and above all, the children of this mental violation.
We say goodbye with the last complaint, which was sent to us. Who knows a state prosecutor who still implements the legislation of the Swiss Code of Obligations in the manner that they should? Here is the simple regulation as a reminder. Decisive is what is desirable or undesirable for the afflicted person, respectively what he or she perceives as sexual harassment.
Thank you for your assistance in answering this question. Good evening.
Goodbye.